This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Theodore Roosevelt, Republican, elected President William Howard Taft, Republican. The United States presidential election of 1908 was the 31st quadrennial presidential election, held on Tuesday, November 3, 1908. Popular incumbent President Theodore Roosevelt, honoring a promise not to seek a third term, persuaded the Republican Party to nominate William Howard Taft, his close friend and Secretary of War, to become his successor, having lost the 1904 election badly with a conservative candidate. The Democratic Party turned to two-time nominee William Jennings Bryan, who had been defeated in 1896 and 1900 by Republican William McKinley. Despite his two previous defeats, Bryan remained extremely popular among the more liberal and populist elements of the Democratic Party. Although he ran a vigorous campaign against the nation's business elite, Bryan suffered the worst loss of his three presidential campaigns. Contents: 1 nominations, 11 Republican Party nomination. 111 Candidates Gallery, 12 Democratic Party nomination, 121 Candidates Gallery, 13 Others, 131 Independence Party nomination, 132 Candidates Gallery, 133 Socialist Party nomination, 134 Candidates Gallery, 2 General Election, 21 Campaign, 22 Results, 23 Geography of Results, 231 Cartographic Gallery, 24 Results by State, 25 Close States, 251 Statistics, 3 Campaign Memorabilia, 4 See also. 5 References, 6 Further Reading, 7 External Links. Nominations: Republican Party Nomination Main Article, 1908 Republican National Convention. Republican Candidates: Charles W. Fairbanks, Vice President of the United States. Joseph B. Foraker, Senator from Ohio. Philander C. Knox, Senator from Pennsylvania. Robert M. La Follette Sr., Senator from Wisconsin. L. M. Shaw, former Secretary of the Treasury. William Howard Taft, Secretary of War. Candidates Gallery: Secretary of War William Howard Taft, Senator Philander C. Knox. From Pennsylvania, Governor Charles E. Hughes. Of New York, Speaker Joseph G. Cannon. From Illinois, Vice President Charles W. Fairbanks. Senator Robert M. La Follette. From Wisconsin, Senator Joseph B. Foraker. From Ohio, L. M. Shaw. From Iowa, Taft. Sherman campaign poster. The Republican nomination contest marked the introduction of the presidential preference primary. The idea of the primary to nominate candidates was sponsored by anti-machine politicians such as New York Governor Charles Evans Hughes and Senator Albert B. Cummins. The first state to hold a presidential primary to select delegates to a national convention was Florida in 1904, when Democratic Party voters held a primary among uninstructed candidates for delegate early in 1908. The only two Republican contenders running nationwide campaigns for the presidential nomination were Secretary of War William Howard Taft and Governor Joseph B. Foraker, both of Ohio. In the nomination contest, 4 states held primaries to select national convention delegates. In Ohio, the state Republican Party held a primary on February 11. Candidates pledged to Taft were printed on the ballot in a Taft column, and candidates pledged to Foraker were printed in a column under his name. Taft won a resounding victory in Ohio. The 3 states holding primaries to select delegates without the preference component were split. California chose a slate of delegates that supported Taft, Wisconsin elected a slate that supported Wisconsin Senator Robert M. La Follette Sr., and Pennsylvania elected a slate that supported its Senator Philander C. Knox. The 1908 Republican Convention was held in Chicago between June 16 and 19. William Howard Taft was nominated with 702 votes to 68 for Knox, 67 for Hughes, 58 for Cannon, 40 for Fairbanks, 25 for La Follette, 16 for Foraker, 3 for President Roosevelt, and 1 abstention. Presidential ballot candidate first unanimous William Howard Taft, 702,980. Philander C. Knox, 68. Charles Evans Hughes, 67. Joseph Gurney Cannon, 58. Charles W. Fairbanks, 40. Robert M. La Follette Sr., 25. Joseph B. Foraker, 16. Theodore Roosevelt, 3. Not voting 1. Representative James S. Sherman from New York received the vice presidential nomination. Vice presidential ballot candidate first unanimous James S. Sherman, 816,980. Franklin Murphy, 77. Curtis Guild Jr., 75. George L. Sheldon, 10. Charles W. Fairbanks, 1. Not voting 1. Democratic Party nomination main article, 1908 Democratic National Convention Democratic candidates, William Jennings Bryan, former U.S. Representative and 1896 and 1900 presidential nominee from Nebraska George Gray, former U.S. Senator from Delaware John Albert Johnson, Governor of Minnesota candidates Gallery William J. Bryan from Nebraska George Gray from Delaware Governor John Albert Johnson of Minnesota. The 1908 Democratic Convention was held in Denver between July 7 and 10 despite a challenge by Minnesota Governor John Albert Johnson, William Jennings Bryan quickly won the overwhelming support of his party. John W. Kern from Indiana was unanimously declared the candidate for vice president without a formal ballot after the names of Charles A. Town, Archibald McNeil, and Clark Howell were withdrawn from consideration. Presidential ballot candidate first unanimous William J. Bryan 8885-1002 George Gray 595 John A. Johnson 46 not voting 8 vice presidential ballot. Candidate first unanimous John W. Kern 1002 Others Independence Party nomination Independence candidates, John T. Graves, journalist from New York William Randolph Hearst, former U.S. representative and newspaper magnate from New York declined Thomas L. Hischen, businessman and former gubernatorial candidate from Massachusetts Milford W. Howard, former U.S. representative from Alabama Reuben R. Leone, lawyer from New York candidates gallery newspaper editor John Temple Graves from Georgia representative and newspaper magnate William Randolph Hearst from New York declined. Businessman Thomas L. Hischen from Massachusetts disappointed with his performance in the 1904 Democratic presidential nomination campaign, and disillusioned as to his chances of successfully attaining it in 1908, William Randolph Hearst decided to run instead on the ticket of a third party of his own making originally born from the Municipal Ownership League, a vehicle for Hearst's ultimately unsuccessful bid for the mayoralty of New York in 1905. It was Hearst's intention to fuse it with the remnants of the Populist Party led by Thomas Watson, a former representative from Georgia who had been its presidential nominee in 1904. However, these intentions were dashed when every candidate that the Independence Party put forth in elections held in New York was elected except Hearst himself. Despite an endorsement by the Democratic Party devastated, Hearst declared his intention never again to be a candidate while Hearst would no longer be the nominee. He fully intended to exercise influence at Independence Party's convention. The platform itself was in large part a statement of his own views with its candidates nominated. The party's purpose was changed from being a path for Hearst's presidential ambitions to being an instrument of his wrath through the influence of his papers and generous financial donations. Hearst hoped that the Independence ticket would draw away votes from William Jennings Bryan and lead to his defeat against Taft, a personal vendetta for Bryan failing to support his own bid for the presidency in 1904. Presidential ballot first second third Thomas L. Hischen 396,590,831 John T. Graves 213-189-7 Milford W. Howard 200-109-38 Reuben R. Leone 71 00 William R. Hearst 49-49-2 Socialist Party nomination Socialist candidates, Eugene V. Debs, Union leader from Indiana Carl D. Thompson, Congregationalist minister from Wisconsin Algie Martin Simons, editor of the International Socialist Review from Illinois candidates gallery Union leader Eugene V. Debs from Indiana Congregationalist minister Carl D. Thompson from Wisconsin editor for the International Socialist Review Algie M. Simons from Illinois Eugene Debs had originally hoped that Bill Haywood, who had attained a national profile from being put on trial for the murder of Frank Steuenberg, of which he was acquitted, would run for the Socialist nomination for president at this time. However, the Socialist Party was fracturing between its radical and more moderate elements, and Debs was deemed the only candidate capable of keeping the party unified. He was overwhelmingly nominated for the presidency on the first ballot, with Benjamin Hanford again named as his running mate. General election campaign. The aging and balding boy orator of the Platte delivers a speech with the free silver issue no longer dominant. Bryan campaigned on a progressive platform attacking government by privilege. His campaign slogan, Shall the People Rule, was featured on numerous posters and campaign memorabilia. However, Taft undercut Bryan's liberal support by accepting some of his reformist ideas, and Roosevelt's progressive policies blurred the distinctions between the parties. Republicans also used the slogan, Vote for Taft Now, You Can Vote for Bryan Anytime, a sarcastic reference to Bryan's two failed previous presidential campaigns. Businessmen continued to support the Republican Party, and Bryan failed to secure the support of labor as a result. result, Bryan ended up with the worst of his three defeats in the national popular vote. He lost almost all the northern states to Taft and the popular vote by 8 percentage points. This would be Bryan's last campaign for the presidency, although he would remain a popular figure within the Democratic Party and in 1912 would play a key role in securing the presidential nomination for Woodrow Wilson. Charles W. Bryan, William's brother, would become the losing Democratic nominee for vice president in 1924. Results by county explicitly indicating the percentage for the winning candidate. Shades of red are for Taft Republican, shades of blue are for Bryan Democratic, and shades of green are for others non-Democratic, non-Republican. Roosevelt handing over his policies to his political protege William H. Taft. 46 states participated, as Oklahoma had joined the Union less than a year before. Bryan won 48 counties in the new state of Oklahoma. The most important increase in number of counties carried by Bryan was in the west-south central section. This was in part due to the vote of newly admitted Oklahoma of the 2,858 counties making returns. Taft won in 1,494, 5,227%, while Bryan carried 1,355. 4,741%, 9,031% counties recorded more votes cast for others than either of the two-party candidates. Taft had a majority in 1,325 counties, while Bryan had a majority in 1,204 counties. By carrying 1,355 counties, Bryan won more counties than he had in 1900, 1,340, but he did not reach or surpass the number of counties he had won in 1896, 1,559. While Bryan won more counties than McKinley in 1896, Bryan failed to carry more counties than the Republican candidate in 1900 or 1904 compared with his strength in previous elections. However, Bryan carried 69 counties in 1908 which had not been Democratic in either 1896 or 1900. Bryan increased the area carried by Democrats in every part of the country except New England and the South. He doubled the number of Democratic counties in Wisconsin and won more counties in Indiana than were carried by plurality vote by the Democrats in any election in the fourth party system except 1912. He made decided gains in Missouri and in Nebraska. Notable were Bryan's victories in Colorado and Nevada, as well as in his home state of Nebraska, but in four western states, Washington, Oregon, Wyoming, and North Dakota, there was not a Democratic county. This was true likewise of Michigan, Delaware, and each of the New England states. The total vote increased greatly, more than a million over that of 1904. Each party shared in the increase, but whereas Taft had nearly 50,000 more than Theodore Roosevelt, Bryan had nearly 1,500,000 more votes than Alton Parker had garnered, and more than in either of his previous campaigns. It was noticeable that the other vote was only about 7,000 less than 4 years earlier. The other vote prevailed in nine counties in the states of Georgia and Texas. The size of the vote cast for the defeated Bryan in 1908 is clear evidence of perhaps the most striking feature of the American presidential vote in this third attempt at the presidency, and in an election following one in which the nominee of his party polled only 5 million votes. Bryan had heavy support in every section of the country, and in every state. Moreover, nearly two-thirds of the vote cast for Bryan was from the 15 states of the northeastern mid-Atlantic, east-north-central, and west-north-central sections, in which the Democratic candidate carried only one state, Nebraska. Despite all conclusions as to predominant sentiment in the different sections and its economic, social, and political causes, there was a national vote cast for Bryan, and it was urban as well as rural. It was eastern, western, southern, and northern. Everywhere the Democratic Party was the minority party, and it was not hopeless, nor was it helpless. It was the agency for the expression of the opposition of almost 6,500,000 voters. Presidential candidate, party, home state, popular vote, electoral vote, running mate. Count. PCT. Vice presidential candidate, home state, elect vote, William Howard Taft. Republican, Ohio. 7,678,335, 5,157%, 321 James S. Sherman. New York. 321 William Jennings Bryan. Democratic, Nebraska. 6,408,979, 4,304%, 162 John W. Kern. Indiana. 162 Eugene V. Debs. Socialist. Indiana. 420,852, 283%, 0 Benjamin Hanford. New York. 0 Eugene W. Chafin. Prohibition. Illinois. 254,087, 171% 0 Aaron S. Watkins, Ohio 0 Thomas L. Hisgen, Independence, Massachusetts 82574 055% 0 John Temple Graves, Georgia 0 Thomas E. Watson, Populist, Georgia 28862 019% 0 Samuel Williams, Indiana 0 August Gilhouse, Socialist Labor, New York 14031 009% 0 Donald L. Monroe, Virginia 0 Other 1519 001% Other, total 14,889,239 100% 483,483 needed to win 242,242 source popular vote. Lape, David 1908 Presidential Election Results Dave Lape's Atlas of U.S. Presidential Elections retrieved September 10, 2012. Bryan 3,354% Geography of results. Results by county, shaded according to winning candidates. Percentage of the vote. Cartographic gallery. Map of presidential election results by county. Map of Republican presidential election results by county. Map of Democratic presidential election results by county. Map of other presidential election results by county. Cartogram of presidential election results by county. Cartogram of Republican presidential election results by county. Cartogram of Democratic presidential election results by county. Cartogram of other presidential election results by county. Results by state. States won by Taft, Sherman. States won by Bryan, Kern. William Howard Taft, Republican. William Jennings Bryan, Democratic. Eugene V. Debs, Socialist. Eugene Chafin, Prohibition. Thomas Hisgen, Independence. Thomas Watson, Populist. August Gilhouse, Socialist. Labor margin. State total. State electoral votes. Hash electoral votes. Hash hash 11,450 138-690-66-497-047 1,576-150-48,830-4,644 105,152 Al, Arkansas 956,624 3,730 87,015 5,731 9 5,842 385 1,026 068 289 019 1,026-068-30,391-2002 151,822 R. California 10,214,398 5,546 10,127,492 3,298 28,659 741 11,770 304 4,278 111 86,906 2,248 386,597 CA Colorado 5 123,693 4,688 126,644 4,805 7,960 302 5,559 211 minus 2,951 minus 112 263,858 CO Connecticut 7 112,915 5,943 768,255 3,592 5,113 269 2,380 125-728-038 608,032 44,660 2,350 190,003 CT Delaware 325,014 5,210 322,055 4,594 239 050 670 140 29 006 2,959 616 48,007 De Florida 5 10,654 2,158 31,104 6,301 5 3,747 759 1,356 275-553 112 1,946 394-20,450-4,143 49,360 FL Georgia 1341,355 3,121 72,355 460 13-584-044 1,452 110-76-006